It's Missy. Welcome back. For today's video, I was inspired by these double Dutch braids and decided to share four different ways to style them. Be sure to let me know which style is your favorite down below in the comment section. Also, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos, and let's get started.
The first thing I'm going to do is part my hair in the center part and clip down the hair on the right side. Then I'm going to create a diagonal part from the center of my forehead on the left side, creating a triangle shaped section, and then I'm just going to clip down the bottom hair to keep it out of the way. Now I'm going to pick up a small piece of hair in this triangle section for my braid, and I'm creating a Dutch braid, so I'm going to split it into three pieces, and then I'm going to start by crossing the side strands under the middle strand for one stitch of the braid. So I'm crossing the right strand under the middle, then I'm crossing the left strand under the middle, then I'm crossing the right strand under the middle, picking up a new section and crossing it under and into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the left strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under and into the middle strand as well. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, continuing the braid, crossing the side strands under the middle strand while bringing small sections into the braid until the braid reaches the crown of my head. Once the braid reaches my crown, I'm going to stop adding new sections into the braid and just continue braiding the hair a little further down, and then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to let down the right section of hair and repeat the same steps, creating a second Dutch braid. So again, I'm going to draw out a diagonal part, dividing off a triangle-shaped section of hair, clipping down the bottom hair. Then I'm going to pick up a small piece near the forehead and split this into three smaller pieces. And I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand to create a second Dutch braid. So I'm bringing small sections into the braid from this triangle section until the braid reaches the crown of my head. Now I'm going to stop adding in new sections and just braid the hair a little further down, and then slide a bobby pin over the end so it doesn't unravel. Once both braids are done, I'm going to take the end of the right braid and remove the bobby pins. Then with a clear elastic band, I'm going to wrap this partway down the section. Then flip the hair around to form a loop, grabbing the base of the bun with my left hand, and then wrap the elastic over the hair a second time to form the bun. Then with the ends left sticking out, I'm just going to loop these back towards the bun and tuck them into the elastic band. And then I'm just going to pull on the edges of the bun to make it bigger and use a bobby pin to pin down any pieces that are sticking out. Now I'm going to repeat those steps with the end of the left braid, so I'm going to slide an elastic band partway down the section of hair, then flip the hair back towards the base to create a loop and grab the base with my left hand. Then I'm just going to wrap the elastic band over the hair to form the bun. And then I'm just going to loop the ends back towards the elastic band and tuck them in. And then I'm just going to grab some bobby pins and pin down any pieces that are sticking out. A second way to wear these braids is with two high buns, so for this version, I'm going to divide the hair into two sections by creating a part line down the back of my head. Then taking the right section of hair, I'm going to brush this up towards the crown of my head where the braids end. Then using a hair elastic, I'm going to create the same buns as before, so I'm just sliding the elastic partway down the hair. Then I'm going to flip the ends up towards the top of my head, grabbing the base with my left hand. Then I'm going to wrap the elastic over the hair to form the bun. And then I'm just going to grab some bobby pins and pin down any pieces that are sticking out. Now I'm just going to do the same thing with the hair on the left side. So I'm combing the hair up to my crown where the braids end, and then I'm going to slide an elastic band over the hair, flip the ends back up towards the top of my head, grabbing the base with my left hand, and then wrap the hair once more with the elastic band. And then I'm just going to grab some bobby pins and pin down any pieces that are sticking out. Then I'm just going to set the style with hairspray and smooth down any flyaways. A third way to style these braids is in a single high bun, so for this bun I'm going to first combine all of my hair together at the top of my head. Then I'm going to wrap it once with a hairband and then twist the hairband over my right hand. Then I can remove the bobby pins from the ends of the braids. Then I'm going to spread the ponytail around the hairband and wrap the hairband over it to form the base of the bun. Then I can just go back and pull on the edges to make the bun a little bit bigger. And then I'm going to take the ends left sticking out and bring these around to the front of the bun. Then I'm just going to loop these back towards the bun and tuck them into the hairband. Then using bobby pins, I'm just going to pin down any sections left sticking out and set the style with hairspray. Now a fourth and final way to style these braids is with a single half-up top knot, so I'm just going to start by combining the ends of the braids, twisting them together. Then I'm going to wrap the twist clockwise at the crown of my head and pull the ends through the middle of the circle. Then I'm just going to continue twisting the ends around the bun, tucking them underneath. And then I'm going to grab a clear elastic band and wrap it over the bun to hold it in place. Then as a last step, I'm just going to spray the style with hairspray and smooth down any flyaways.
Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. Be sure to let me know in the comment section which style was your favorite. Also, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos, and I will see you next time.